Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about transmission electron microscopy. It's also called TEM. It is very important topic from scattering spectroscopy, and it is also very important type of electron microscopy. Basically, electron microscopy are two type. One is SEM, second is TEM. SEM, scanning electron microscopy, in my previous video, I discuss about scanning electron microscopy, and in this particular video, I discuss complete explanation about transmission electron microscopy. So why we use transmission electron microscopy? So basically, in general, we use optical or light microscope in our labs, in our school labs or college labs. But when we want some magnified image, some very resolution powers image, so we have to use transmission electron microscopy or scanning electron microscopy, because both are very very good to very good types of microscopy which give the detailed explanations, microstructures of any kind of sample. So transmission electron microscope is very important to get magnified image. Okay, so what is transmission electron microscope? The basic introduction is TEM is a technique of choice for analysis of internal microstructure. So basically, we get internal microstructure to use TEM. So TEM is also used for evaluation of nanostructures like fibers, particles, or microstructures of cells. It invented by Max Knoll and Ernst Rutsker. This is the basic introduction of transmission electron microscopy. When we go to principle of a transmission microscopy, so the theory portion of principle of TEM, the theory portion is electron, those are passed through the sample or specimen, are imaged and give the idea about the internal structure of the sample. This is the first point, very important point of that principle. First we discuss the theory portion of that principle, then we understood the concept from diagram. So first point is electron, those are passed through the sample or specimen, are imaged and give the idea about the internal structure of the sample. Second important point is electron transmitted through the sample will strike into the fluorescence screen or plate, and it will be converted into image which is 2D or black and white. This is the basic important point, theory point of principle. So what is actually happens in principle? This is the important diagram for that. Actually, this is we use radiation. We use radiation source. We use electron beam for radiation source. This is the electron beams, and when this electron beam strike our sample, a specimen, three kind of signal we get. First is secondary electron. Second is backscatter electron, X-rays, and fourth is transmitted electron. In scanning electron microscopy, we get image to use these three kind of signals. But in transmission electron microscope, we get our image through this fluorescence screen. When transmitted electrons strike this screen, then some kind of signal get from there, and these signals are go to our CPU. And then from in monitor we get the image. So this kind of principle, transmission electron microscopies are work in that principle. In our scanning electron microscopy, we get image from using this three kind of a signal, and in our transmission electron microscopy, we get image to using this transmitted electrons. Okay, so this is the basic principle of that, and some important point, I hope you get it. And some important point of instrumentation is electron gun is used to produce electron beam and operate at 1 to 30 kilowatt for SEM and 80 to 300 kilowatt for TEM. And tungsten filament is used in electron gun which emit beam of electron at very high voltage. This is some very important point of transmission electron microscopy. Now move to the instrumentation of electron microscopy. This is a ray diagram of transmission electron microscopy and its instrumentation part. We discuss some important parts of that ray diagram, that instrumentation of electron transmission electron microscopy. First is electron source. In electron source, we generally use electron gun to produce the electron beam. Okay, first we saw the some important parts is electron source, condenser lens, objective lens and projective lens, and this is the screen. So this four is very important kind of part of that instrumentation. So first we discussed the theory portion of that instrumentation, then we better understand the instrumentation of this diagram, from this diagram. So first important part is obviously electron source, that we use electron gun to produce electron beam. So tungsten filament is used for produce of electron beam in electron gun. And second important part of that instrument is condenser lens. These are electromagnetic lenses and they will focus all the electron beam toward the specimen or sample. In time, number of condenser lens are much higher as compared to scanning electron microscopy. So electron beam will be more accelerated and it can easily penetrate the specimen. Okay, this is the very important parts of that instrument, electron gun and condenser lens. Then we use sample. So sample preparation method is also very important in scanning electron microscope also, and in transmission electron microscope. So we use four kind of method to prepare our sample. First is fixation, second is rinsing, third is secondary fixation, fourth is dehydration. So for fixation we use two kind of method, that is chemical fixation and cryofixation. So for chemical fixation we use glutaraldehyde, and for cryofixation we use liquid nitrogen and helium. For rinsing we use sodium cocadilate. This is the important chemical compound we use to rinsing our sample. And third is secondary fixation. We use osmium tetraoxide, OS O4, and in for dehydration we use ethanol or acetone. Okay, this is the important methods for prepare our sample, and this is important chemical compounds to prepare our methods. I hope you get understand, and this is very very important in instrument because we have to thus prepare our sample very well, that's then we get very good image. Third is objective lens. It is also very important. Objective lens, it is also an electromagnetic lens and focus for transmitted beam toward the projector lens. And fourth is projector lens. It will magnify the transmitted beam coming from the objective lens and focus toward the fluorescence screen, CCD detector. It's also called CCD detector. Projector lens is also important type of that instrument. It will magnify the transmitted beam coming from the objective lens and focus toward the fluorescence screens, or CCD detector. So what is CCD detector? It's a charge coupled detector. We'll send the data to CPU. Okay, this is the final stage that we get our beam, we get our image, and this would send the data. Yeah, this is the final state that there we get our data, and this data will send to CPU. Okay, from CCD detector. So this is the important parts of that instrument. For important part, I hope you understand. I hope these notes will be helpful for your examination exam preparations. And now the instrument. So I think you should understand from principal parts of that instrument. Basically, this electron source, we use electron gun to produce electron beam, and then condenser lens. This is the in yellow part. It is the electron beam, and this condenser lens generally focus all the electron beam toward the specimen or sample. We take a sample in there, and then objective lens. It's also has very important work. It's all focus all the electron beam to the projective lens, and then after this projective lens we get our data in this fluorescence screens. We use that, and after we use this data we get the magnified, very good, more magnified image in our computer screen. So this is the instrumentation part of transmission electron microscope. I hope it will be helpful for your concept, understanding the concept. And very important point is TEM is operated under vacuum to reduce the any kind of interference by ear. So basically all the instrumentation is happening in vacuum. Okay, so now the application parts of this TEM, transmission electron microscope application, is very important for any kind of topic because it is something very important for our exam point of view. So what is the application of TEM? First is TEM provide topographical, morphological, compositional and crystalline information about our sample. So this is the very very important. And the image allow researchers to view sample on a molecular level, making it possible to analyze structure and texture. This is very important application again. And third important application is cancer researcher studies of tumor cell ultrastructure by using transmission electron microscope. So basically this is the important applications of TEM. Now the advantage of TEM, there's many kind of advantage of TEM. First is TEM offer very powerful magnification and resolutions, and that's why we use TEM. And second is TEM provide information and element and compound structure. Images are high quality and detailed. Okay, this is a very important advantage of TEM, but there is disadvantage also of TEM. So what is kind of disadvantage is, first is TEMs are large and very expensive. One of the very important disadvantage, I think. And second is laboratory sample preparations. Third is operation and analysis required special training. Fourth is TEM required special housing and maintenance. Image are black and white. These are the disadvantage of TEM. So that's it for this is the end of the video. I hope this would be helpful for your exam preparations, any kind of exam preparations. And this is something which I also try new things. I also want to learn new things. That's why I try to do that. I hope my notes and my efforts will be helpful for your exam preparations. And if you like the video, please support, like, share, and subscribe to my channel and stay connected with my channel. Thank you so much for watching.